So here we are, ready to build some vertical stabilizers. But before we start, we check all the materials, even the plans and also the tools, if really everything is ready to build up these. Because if we mention middle in the building process, oh, there is something missing, we really get in trouble. That's why I take my time and check carefully everything that is needed to build up these. At first, I take a look in the building plan. There are all notes for the materials and even the tools that are needed. And so I complete my tools and materials. For instance, these Kevlar stripes, these glass fiber stripes, and check if the mold is ready. Here we see the tools that are needed. This is a small brush, then this special scissor and our roll. Here we got the resin and the hardener. I use the L385 resin and H386 hardener. They have an aeronautical certificate and give very good results even in very thin applications. I also check the room temperature and humidity. The temperature should be about 20 to 25 degrees and the humidity should not be over 70%. So everything is nice and we can start with the building process. So let's mix the resin. We need 10 grams for the first moment, because we build very light and we want to have always fresh resin. So okay, 10 gram resin and also 3.5 gram hardener. Now we go over to the mixing machine. It's always good to use a transparent cup, because then you can see if everything is mixed correctly, and that's very important for the hardening process of the resin. The first step is to mark the position of the rovings, of the spar rovings. And this I do with this pencil. Here we have the position. I already marked them here on the outside and I just put it also in the inside. And the lines that are not so good visible, I remark here. This is for instance the outer line of the rudder. And all these marks are very important for the layup. And I do it also here. We just put the resin on that areas we want to laminate something, and this is the outer area. They will be reinforced. On the trailing edge I put a glass roving, because up here is a satellite receiver, could be inbuilt, and that the satellite receiver can work fine. There shouldn't be any carbon fibers around it, because they absorb this, the signal, and can disturb it. Next is this edge. There I will put two glass fiber rovings, because this is a higher edge or a deeper one, and I will be sure that the 25 gram glass fiber already stays on it. This could be also done with cotton flocs or micro balloons, but they are not so solid, and even they do not stay that good in position. They can move and swim away, and this can cause problems. That's why I like for this more the roving. So, and here is no problem with the receiver. So we can use the lighter material, and that's the carbon fiber. That's a 800 tex roving. And that roving goes exactly to the edge, that we have a very solid edge. And next is these 25 gram glass fiber. And here we have to be very careful. This material is a bit complicated. So, and what we do now is to position it without any wrinkles. That's the important part, that every fiber is in its unique direction and that we don't have any wrinkles before we go on with the laminating process. You see all over here is excess, and this is wanted because when it ends at the edge of the mold, it would go up and cause problems while the vacuum process. So, and now we start from the center with the laminating. And for this, we take our roll, and now we start here from the center and impregnate the fibers. And we always have an eye on any wrinkles, because the stability of this part is caused by the fiber direction. The fiber direction should have been absolutely straight. If they are curved, they lose their stability, and that is what we do not want. So after this inner area is laminated, we go on with the outside. No fiber ever should be dry. All fibers should be laminated. And what you see here is a line, and this line, this is the end of the laminating area. Out of this line, I want to do the sealing for the vacuum process. So I take care that I do not go over this line. Now we go on with the reinforcements. Here on the nose section, we put in a stripe of 50 gram glass fibers to reinforce that areas. And this time we put it exactly to the edge. So next is the hinge of the rudder. Here we got 36 gram of Kevlar fiber with 45 degree fiber orientation. That's very important for a good work of this hinge. So next is the spar cap, that's a roving, a 400 tex roving, and this just goes up to the area where the satellite sits. On this roving, it's important that they lie really flat and even without any wrinkles. I press it even more flat. Here is a 50 gram glass stripe needed as reinforcement. So now the first mold is ready, and let's go on with the next one. So both vertical stabilizer molds are laminated now, and we can go on with the wing mold. Here's the plan. The wing is a little bit more complicated, but we want to do it now. The first step is again marking all important areas. First we put some resins to the area where we will later put on the roving. done. We got the two wing shells and also the two vertical stabilizer shells, and they will cure till tomorrow, and then we will go on with the next step, honeycombs and the inner layer, and this will be done by Rocky Oven. So here we are, one day is over and the resin is pre-hardened. For a good bonding result, we roughen the surface with this scratch cloth. There we want to scratch the surface. Let's grab a mold. These are the canards and the elevators. And then we want to scratch now and make them ready for the next step. So next is a checkup of all the tools and materials we will need for this step. For instance, here we got our sealing, this is our acryl, and also a second one. Then we have a vacuum cleaner, this is for pre-vacuuming. So we check it up, it's running, okay. Then we go over to the vacuum pumps. They are here, yeah. I checked them, if they are running, good. We will need nearly all of them, I think 6. Then the oven, anything in the oven? No, oven is 3, okay, that's nice. And so, we do go on. Here we have all the vacuum films, yeah, they are already prepared. Next is we can go to the composite room and start laminating. Let's go! And this time we also put in a little bit of white paint and cotton flocks and also Tixo. This is Tixotropia agent, Tixotroph agent. Now we bring this to the surface, and now you see the reason why I make it white. That's because it's better visible, because I should not forget any spot. So, next are the gloves. This we do with our roll and the hybrid fibers. So next is putting the honeycombs on the mold. We put on the fibers. So now we are in the assembly room with all the pre-filled molds, and the next step is the vacuum process. So, now all parts in the oven. The oven will heat up to about 50 degrees Celsius. And from time to time, I will check the vacuum pressure and also the temperature. And tomorrow, I think they can be demolded. So now the molds are back from the oven and they are ready to demold and shake out how the parts look like. And this we will do in the next part. So have a great day and see ya. Bye bye.